Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we are going to learn about the NFC technology. I am sure most of you are already aware about this technology and many of you have used this technology in your smartphone or tablet for sharing the photos with your friends. And perhaps you might have used this technology for pairing the Bluetooth speaker and the smartwatches. In fact, because of this technology, we are able to use the mobile payment services like Google Pay, Samsung Pay and the Apple Pay. So let's understand in this video, what is NFC, how this NFC works, what are the different applications of NFC and what are the advantages of NFC over the technologies like Bluetooth, RFID and the QR code. So this NFC stands for the near field communication, and as its name suggests, it is a short distance wireless communication technology. So when two NFC enabled devices are very close to each other, roughly around 4 cm, then they can communicate with each other using the radio waves. Now, out of the two communicating devices, at least one device has to be an active device like smartphone, tablet or the payment terminal, while the other device can be active or the passive. And the example of the passive device is the NFC tags. Now here, the active device means the device which requires the external power supply, while the passive device does not require any external power supply and it is powered by the electromagnetic field of the active device. So after having a little background about this NFC, now let us understand how this NFC works and how NFC enabled devices can communicate with each other. So like I said earlier, these NFC enabled devices communicates with each other using the radio waves, and these radio waves are generated using the antenna. So if we take the case of smartphone, then antenna is fitted on the battery like this, or sometimes it is fitted on the back side of the back cover. While in case of the NFC tag, if you tear down the tag, then you will find the antenna pattern like this. So using these antennas, these devices are able to communicate with each other. Now this NFC supports the three modes of communication. The first is the card emulation mode, second is the peer-to-peer communication mode, and third is the reader or the writer mode. So first, let us talk about the peer-to-peer communication mode. And the example of this mode is when we are sharing the information using the two smartphones. Now in this mode, the both devices are active devices and they can communicate with each other by generating the radio waves alternatively. It means that when one device transmits the data, at that time, the second device only listens to it and it does not generate its own radio waves. Similarly, when the second device transmits the data, at that time, the first device only listens to it and it does not generate its own radio waves. So in this mode, both devices generate the radio wave alternatively at the carrier frequency of 13.56 MHz. And using this, they can share information and files with each other. So this is all about the peer-to-peer communication mode. Now let us talk about the second mode, that is reader or writer mode. And the example of this mode is when we are accessing the data or information using the smartphone from the NFC tag. So this mode of operation is very similar to the RFID. So in this mode, the active device like smartphone or tablet reads or writes the data on the NFC tag using the principle of electromagnetic induction. Now to read the information from the NFC tag, the active device generates the radio wave at the carrier frequency of 13.56 MHz. So these waves used to get coupled to the antenna of the passive tag, and from these electromagnetic waves, NFC tag receives the power. So this time varying electromagnetic field generates the EMF or the voltage in this passive tag. So this generated voltage is rectified using the rectifier and it is used to power up the chip inside this NFC tag. Now this small chip generally comprises of clock, EEPROM, rectifier circuit and the small controller. So once the chip is powered up, then the tag responds back to the active device by the technique which is known as the load modulation. So in this technique, the tag uses the internal clock of the chip and it generates the auxiliary carrier frequency of 848 kHz. Now depending on the stored data inside this chip, the load which is connected in parallel to the antenna is turned on and off. And in this way, the data is sent back to the active device. So in this way, by the principle of electromagnetic induction, the passive tag receives the power and using the load modulation, the data is sent back to the active device. So this is all about the reader and the writer mode. Now let us talk about the third mode, which is known as the card emulation mode. So example of this mode is when smartphones are used for the mobile payments. So in this mode, both device used to be a active device. Generally, the one device used to be a smartphone and the second device obviously used to be a payment terminal. But in this mode, the smartphones acts like a passive smart card. So they do not generate their own radio waves, but they only responds back to the requested data by the payment terminal. So in a way, the smartphone acts like a passive device. So the operating principle of this mode is very similar to the reader or writer mode. So these are the three supported modes of communication by the NFC. Now, in this NFC, some standards are defined to establish the communication between the two devices. And in these standards, certain parameters are defined, like what should be the operating frequency or the carrier frequency of the radio waves, what type of coding scheme should be used, what modulation technique should be used, and what should be the data rate for the information sharing. So these standards are derived from the already existing standards which are used for the radio communication. And these standards are known as the NFC-A, NFC-B, NFC-F and NFC-5. So here is a table which summarizes some of the parameters which are defined under these standards. So that is being said, now let us see some useful application of the NFC. Now many applications are already known to us, and in fact we are already using NFC for these applications, like for file sharing, for mobile payment, for pairing the different devices, and for information sharing using the smart posters and the business cards. But apart from that, it can be used for the home automation, for healthcare, in library systems, or even for the personal usage. So at home, just by tapping the NFC tag using the smartphones, we can change the brightness of the ambient light, or it is also possible to change the temperature of the AC, or even we can automatically close the doors using this NFC. So these are the some of the applications in which the NFC can be used at our homes. Similarly, in the healthcare, just by tapping the mobile to the patient's NFC tag, you can get the required information and the history about the patient very quickly. Moreover that, these NFC tags can be used for the personal usage. Like just by tapping the NFC tag, we can change the setting of our smartphone. So just by tapping the NFC tag, we can turn on the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi in our smartphone, or we can open particular app or game in our smartphone. So there are many Android apps are available using which it is possible to write on these NFC tags. The most popular among all is NFC tools. So using this app, it is possible to write on the NFC tags. And in fact, it also shows the number of bytes that is required to write a particular code or URL in the NFC tag. And using the another app called Trigger, we can assign the different tasks which should be get performed once this NFC tag is detected. Like when you are in the car, then just by tapping the NFC tag, we can start the navigation in our phone. And once we reach the office, then just by tapping the tag on the desk, we can turn the silent profile on our phone. So these are the some of the applications in which NFC can be used. Alright, so far we understood what is NFC, how this NFC works, and we have seen some useful applications of this NFC. Now let us compare this NFC with the different technologies like Bluetooth, RFID and the QR code. So first, let us compare this NFC with the Bluetooth. So this Bluetooth is also wireless communication technology, and using this we can share the information and file with the different devices. And in fact, the data rate at which the information can be shared on Bluetooth is quite high compared to NFC. But in case of Bluetooth, the time that is required for pairing the device is more compared to NFC. In fact, in NFC, the two devices can be set up in less than 0.1 second. And that is why today in many devices, NFC is used for pairing the different devices. And once the pairing between the device is established, then for communication either Bluetooth or Wi-Fi is used. So now let us compare NFC with the RFID. So this NFC is derived from the RFID standards, and in fact the working principle of NFC is quite similar to the RFID. But this RFID works on the different frequencies, starting from the low frequency up to the ultra high frequencies. But NFC works on the particular frequency band, that is 13.56 MHz band. So that is the one difference between NFC and the RFID. Now in case of RFID, the reader sends the request to the RFID tag, and in response, RFID tag replies back to the reader. So we can say that there is only one way communication possible in case of RFID, while in case of NFC, it is also possible to have a peer-to-peer communication. That means two devices can communicate with each other alternatively. So that is the difference between NFC and the RFIDs. Now let us compare this NFC with the QR code. So this QR code technology can also be used in some applications where these NFC tags are used. For example, using this QR code, we can open some applications or we can provide the additional information to the customer about the product. So in a way, this QR code can also be used in place of NFC tags. But to access the information, we need to scan this QR code using the mobiles. While in case of NFC, just by tapping the mobile to the NFC tag, the information can be easily accessed. So we can say that the access time that is required in case of NFC is less than the QR code. Moreover, that this NFC is more secure than the QR code, because in case of QR code, it can be replaced by putting the another QR code on top of it. While in case of NFC, if someone puts another NFC tag on top of it, then neither of the tag can be get accessed. So in a way, NFC technology is more secure than the QR code technology. So this is all about the comparison of NFC with the different technologies like QR code, Bluetooth and the RFID. So I hope in this video you understood what is NFC, how this NFC works and what are the different applications in which the NFC can be used. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.